It's nice to wake up to something you didn't expect. Well, something like this anyway. I received a message from Ben Carroll, a very wise and dear soul I met through the Panic to Freedom forums. When I asked if I could turn his message into the next shift video, he responded,
"Absolutely, yes. Thank you. I would be deeply honored. I may have written the words in the form they are in, but they are deeply influenced by many teachings I've been blessed with from many amazing teachers, you included, and life experiences directly related to those teachings. I believe the message is very important. There needs to be a lot more we and a lot less I in our lives."
Thank you, Ben. We are the ones we have been looking for all this time. What follows is the message I received from Ben. We have forgotten how to be human. Connection is the seat of human experience. Denying to ourselves that we're deeply connected is to fight who and what we truly are. We are human. Humans are an interconnected species, deeply connected to one another, connected to the Earth, connected to the Sun and solar system, connected to the galaxy, connected to the universe, above and below. But this is the age of the individual, the great age of the all-important I, where we have been trained and ingrained to forget that we are deeply connected to all that is, that we are solitary individuals that must struggle to come out ahead over other individuals, and then ruthlessly defend what we acquire through these struggles in order to secure a place for ourselves in this unending social ladder, power struggle of a world. This belief in disconnection causes us to feel unsettled inside because we're fighting our true nature of interconnectedness. We continually struggle against our true nature, and this causes much turmoil within, anxiety, the great social plague of our time. A quick Google search for common anxiety medications comes up with a prescription drug list much longer than the whole of this wordy post. From Ativan to Xanax, a laundry list of chemicals to treat the symptoms of our body telling us something is wrong. Something is wrong here. Something is wrong. What is it? We have forgotten how to be human. We are born human. But then we are slowly assimilated into this culture of perceived separation. We're trained to unsee the connection by people that have been trained to unsee the connection themselves, by others that have been trained to unsee the connection by those before them. The connection is still here. We've just forgotten. Society has blocked out and blacklisted all the symptoms of human connectedness as woo-hoo, fodder for the feeble-minded, superstitious, new-agey kooks in the world. Without this connection, we've forgotten how to be truly human, and this suppression causes us great anxiety. Saturday, while waiting for a flight at the airport, people watching, I had an amazing vision of the interconnection between humans. Through streaking lights and swirling vortices of unseen forces, I saw how each and every person is just a fragment of the perception of the whole. Each person is a part of the one experiencing an illusion of separation. Just below the superficial surface, there is a single interconnecting current that we are all literally right on top of, directly drawing from. We get so completely pulled into the illusion of separation, so fully engulfed in I, that we struggle with how to even survive in this world. Survival. A very serious problem for us in a state of separation. This serious struggle for survival causes fear, anxiety, depression, loneliness, self-pity, jealousy, greed, hate, seriously bad experiences. But all this seriousness is a mistake of time. In this moment of vision, I understood how time does not exist, but saw how everything is just a piece of one infinite moment that includes all potentials that ever have and ever will exist. We don't move through time. That is an illusion. We move from potential moment to to potential moment in an endless string of potential moments that includes every possibility, every potential, within one infinite, whole moment. All times are now. Every possibility already exists and are already happening right now. Time is an illusion that we create for ourselves through connecting these strings of potential moments. Everything and every experience is available to everyone at all times. The ultimate abundance is your birthright. The conundrum is, how do we shift away from where we are? How do we make greater and greater shifts between these potentials? We are all part of one connected consciousness. How can we start to awaken our deeper connection to one another? Is the heart the key? Is it all just manipulation of vibrations through the electromagnetic field? If so, how do we become conscious of these manipulations? Things are changing. People are becoming more aware. I have a feeling questions like these may have very realistic answers coming in the not-so-distant future. I hope for that, at least. That is the potential I wish to experience. It's hard to accurately assign words sometimes. It's like when Julia Roberts trying to eat snails in Pretty Woman. When I try to pin it down, it shoots away. Slippery little suckers. But with our interconnectedness, when we don't try and pin it down, when we just let it envelop us, then we know this all intuitively. To know the connection, we must flow with it, not try and pin it down. Be the light in this world.
Happiness runs in a circular motion. Thought is like a little boat upon the sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. You can have everything if you let yourself be. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs, happiness runs. Happiness runs in a circular motion. Thought is like a little boat upon the sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. You can have everything if you let yourself see. Happiness runs, happiness runs.